Hey, what up, party people? Comedian Ron G, and welcome to Chocolate Sundays Year in Review 2023. Chocolate Sundays is at the world famous Laugh Factory, and we're going to do a recap on all the weirdest, the wildest, the craziest, and the cringiest moments of 2023. Check it out. Don't block your blessing. Yeah. So first up is Flavor of Love. This couple won VIP a few months back, and they never stopped coming. They literally come here every single week and sit in the front row. Now, Jay, he has tattoos from head to toe. He kind of looked like one of those desks from middle school with the gum and all the writing on it. And then Ari, she's known for other reasons. And the comedians always noticed.
It's somebody's birthday today, and we're going to call her up here. We're going to celebrate her, right? So we're going to show her a good time. How the fuck did you get a Chipotle burrito in this bitch? I don't care what gang you from. You gonna answer me tonight. How did you sneak a whole goddamn chip and then eat it on the low like you not in the front, nigga? Like, they gonna hand it back to her, she put in her dress.
If you could do me a favor, bro, if you could hold the phone for myself. I know you got your girl thigh in your... Yeah, hi, Mom.
Hey, guys. It's your girl, Takara Williams. Chocolate Sunday's very first female host here. And what is my favorite moment of 2003 at Chocolate Sundays at the Laugh Factory? And I'm probably going to go with, we had a couple. They won one-time VIP entry into Chocolate Sundays. They never stopped coming. We absolutely love them. They've been here almost every Sunday, like clockwork. Black couple, guy's got tattoos all over his head, woman is gorgeous, fat ass. And he's okay with her popping it on stage. Like one time he got on stage and grabbed her ass and shook it. And I was like, oh, that's crazy. Wow. And it was nice for me, even. And best of 2023 is when you get people who love the show so much that even after their VIP entry wears out, they still come every week like clockwork, showing love, buying tickets. And we love that. So Chocolate Sunday, salute to you. I know you, but I don't want to say where I know you from. But I appreciate you. And that's it.
Anybody want to come up here and twerk for me? Somebody say, yes, I will. Who said that? Where you at? Come up here. Come on. All right, come on. Drop the beat for her since she want to come up here and twerk.
Bounce it. Bounce it.
Hell no. You see the girl face. Stop it. You know goddamn well you don't be talking like that.
Come on, yeah. Come up here.
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah.
You're an alumni!
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah.
Yes!
Come
on. Yes, get up here! He said it all right! Hey!
Hey! Hey! Whoa, 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 it's a family.
You're gonna get us shut down! Huh?
We can keep it going.
That's her man. He said, show them what I'm getting in the house. That's my shit. Niggas up here talking shit about me, talking about something. I ain't your one. Go show them I'm your one. And the whole time she twerking, he my one, he my one, he my one, he my one. Wait, but the girl with the green, she said, she didn't even do that. They said, bounce that ass. She said,
and she was studying.
Like her pastor was in here or some shit.
Boy, you know your shirt ain't about. Hey, man, listen, BT Kingsley here. Chocolate Sundays. When we want to show you some love, we might talk about you a little bit. We might get on you. Might Joan, Rose, Frank. We call it, depending on where you're from, you know, we gonna probably talk about you a little bit. But that's okay. It's all in love. These are the best. Roast ranks, jokes, caps, snaps, bidibidaps of the year. Kingsley.
How you doing, ma'am? I ain't got no joke, relax. You look good, like, your girl, stand up, show them the outfit, show them the outfit. Yeah. Shirt look like when your TV stopped working. I guess I gotta read.
He don't give a fuck about what's going on. He tearing them chips up, bitch. Bitch, he tearing them chips. No, no. I was watching from back there. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? This is like, oh, you gotta feed him. You can't bring him out the house like this. You got to feed this nigga. I heard him. Every time it was quiet, I heard the chips. I had to stand up. I'm like, who the fuck is that? This tall nigga. Full Cookie Monster on the chips, bitch. Just, god damn. That's your husband? That's your man? Oh, that's a... Oh, why the fuck you over here? This shit wild as fuck. There's some polygamy shit going on over here. That's the fuck going on over here. Telling my two wives, sit over there, I'ma chill. My knees gonna be touching the stage, but it's cool. That's your husband? He chew bad in the house, I know he do. I know when you mad at him, that's all you see. Look at this stupid motherfucker chewing hard. Dumbass, close your mouth, stupid. When a woman is mad at her man, everything piss you off. And why the fuck you walk like that? Since when the fuck you start walking like this, stupid ass? So you just let him sit over there and fuck up they night. They can't hear shit because he chewing like this. Just chewing loud. They chips. Like, you open up your mouth wide. It's a chip. You just slide it in like a Pringle. You, oh, yum, 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 yum. It's like a two-year-old eating his first chip. Just a mess.
Give it up for everybody, y'all. So, what's my man named Biggs? Yeah. Yeah, I walked past, he said, hey, man, I'm a big fan. I said, you ain't bullshit. My nigga Mark Smith up here looking like a Baptist Build-A-Bear.
I fucked him up tonight, you hear me? Y'all ain't never seen no nigga with a wood brim and marble hat. You hear me? Killed him. Fatality.
That boy was sharp than a motherfucker. I was like, God damn, that nigga's suit. That nigga vest and jacket was together. He's like, no, not the pants. Let me get the vest in the jacket, and, let me get a tie with that. A large tie with that. Every time I see him, he got a new suit on. And the vest be the same color as the jacket, and I'd be like, man, you gotta be the banker on Monopoly when you play. I'll handle the money, thank you very much. You know what's crazy about Henry Coleman is that the nigga's so articulate and nasty.
I eat my girl ass first because it makes her pussy taste better.
It's like watching Martin Luther King talk free. So he said, you know, and then, you know, the booty hole, you understand? And that ass meat. That ass meat and that pussy meat. Like, god damn, nigga, this shit. Give it up for Edgar one more time. Man, I wish I had an accent, man. That should be sounding sweet as hell. It's just like everything he said was making me want to rally behind him. He said, they can never take that away from us. Never take it away from us.
We don't know how to laugh at ourselves. And when we learn how to laugh at ourselves, the world could be better.
They can never have the laugh, fucker. Like, oh, shit. I will vote for this nigga. They will never take it away, never. We have our lives and how come when you got an accent, you'll never know what you finna say next? They be like, and you know, like, come on, man, what the fuck?
If y'all didn't dress up, I'm giving you outfits, Heavy D. God damn it. You Heavy D, nigga, tonight.
Y'all the bitches I'ma kill. I'ma stab y'all up for this movie over with. What the fuck is going on? Action Bronson? He's like, who the fuck is Action Bronson? You, Action! You're a little bigger than Action Bronson. You know Action Bronson. You think about it, Bronson. Got uncomfortable, man. They should have sat you in the chair, bro. That booth ain't doing you no justice, bro. That boy's spilling up out that thing, ain't he? That boy's... You gotta tuck your back into the booth. You can't be spilling out the booth like that. Spilling out the booth in the house. That's uncomfortable. You're bigger than Action, though. No, you're not. Action bigger than you. If y'all wrestle, who win? Oh, I didn't even see this bullshit over here. Oh, I don't even know what this is. Are you George Washington? What are you? Who are you? Huh? He a weed doctor? Not you, nigga. The nigga behind you. With the gold dreads. I know y'all little bullshit ass outfit. I'm talking about the nigga behind you with the golden locks. He told me, we weed doctor. We know, we get it, we saw. Y'all did ate all the product. So I'm not talking about y'all. I'm talking about the brother behind you. Who are you, sir? He said he Game of Thrones. You should have wore some white face, sir. Because you're too dark to be Game of Thrones. Unless you wanted the dragons. Dracarys! You can't be the goddamn Game of Thrones. You're too dark to be Game of Thrones with gold locks, nigga. I thought you was T'Challa mama, nigga.
Okay, so what's up, y'all? You know, Kanye has his Sunday service, but we got something a little bit better, and that is the Chocolate Sunday service. So let's get into some of the best musical moments from 2023.
Is there any AKAs in here? Here you is. Is that song in violation or is that cool?
It's cool.
She's like, it is. That's Sexy Red. You can't whoop that bitch though.
Take this next verse, nigga. Me, it's me. I'm the problem, it's me. It's me.
Eat that shit up, nigga. You never thought you would have an opportunity to do that shit. You about to fuck all them Ohio bitches. When you get back, you viral, nigga. Get a TikTok page right now. You killed that shit. I did not expect that from you, nigga. I thought you just came back from storming the Capitol, nigga. That's what you look like. One of them niggas, stop playing, nigga. Stop playing.
Come on up here, my man. Let's go. Let's go, sir. You ready? Show him a little something. Put your foot on the wall. Let's go. Put your foot on the wall. Let's go. Mouth wipe. Wipe your mouth. Wipe your mouth. Nose pinch. Lick your lips. Rub your chest and go get her. Go kiss her in the mouth. Go kiss her in the mouth and go get her. He went for the black girl. His girl was recording. I thought he was going to her. He went to the... she missed the whole moment. She was recording. Like, he's not coming to me. He's not... Wait, he's not...
right, cut it, cut it. One more time for a white boy with the Disney hair. Well, yeah. That's crazy. It's Black History Month. That's wild. We just got white boys up in here shucking and jiving and shit. That's crazy. That's the energy we on Chuckle Sundays, huh? All right. Respect. That's crazy. Boy came over here looking like Jonathan Taylor Thomas in this motherfucker. Nigga had a hella nostalgic look, right, nigga? I ain't like it because you... you with a white girl, but you be talking to Black girls. That's your sister? Yeah. That's what I thought. I love being Black. We can just say shit. Yeah, it's your sister? Yeah. That's what I thought, nigga. Better have been related. Shit. Come up and hear all that whoop wop. Yeah. I was back there ready to perform. I see you do your shit. I was like, word. This is what I gotta follow. All the Black girls low-key interested, nigga. You the biggest mystery of the night. You know what I'm saying? Oh, they over here trying to guess your inches and shit. I'm letting you know, bro. Hey, sis, let him do his thing outside. He gonna have some visitors.
Like, that was planned almost. That's hilarious. And ma'am, you didn't let me get it out of my mouth. I was like, sir, let her be. She didn't let me finish. And she stepped over three Black people to get up here. I'm like, my God. You pushed her glasses. This is what Dr. King wanted. We bridging the gap. This is what this country needs. Play it one more time. Hey! Cut it off. Come on, Barbara. Jeez, Barbara. You had one job. Stan took his hat off him. It was like some nunchucks. She's... It was your chance, Barbara. I don't want to hear it now. You had your shot. You ready? Yes, you. Are you ready? We waiting on you. Let's go. Yeah.
like Thor hammer. She did it like this and the hat just flew in her hand.
Hey, Ron, she was serious as fuck. She
you saw the hat? Serious. You saw Thor when he do like this and the hammer just come? Her hat just showed up out of nowhere. Just put it up.
She was serious, her.
Oh, pelvis, get this pelvis.
You don't call me.
Get this mayonnaise pelvis. Come get this pelvis. Get this pelvis right here.
Gluten-free pelvis.
Oh, this gluten-free. Boiled with a pinch of salt. Come get this pelvis.
No salt.
Get this granola. Granola. Nougat. Get this nougat. Trail mix. Bagels. Cream cheese.
What's up, man? I'm comedian Cindy Castillo, and I'll be hosting Chocolate Sunday sometimes. And listen, man, sometimes it's cracking. We have a good time up here. And sometimes people be bombing up here, or whatever this was. Now look, we about to look at the cringiest moment of 2023. And when we do this, I don't want you to feel bad. Oh, Cindy, you being mean, I want you to laugh. Because this person practiced, they rehearsed in a mirror. Obviously don't have any best friends, because a best friend would say, hey baby, you need to stick to accounting. So when you look at this, don't feel bad. Pray for the young lady. Pray for everybody like this. Because what the fuck is a knee out? Can we just talk about it? What the fuck is a knee out? It made me uncomfortable. And I'm rooting for everybody on stage. I'm upstairs rooting for you. But when I got to put down my wine to listen to the uncomfortability, you make the list of the cringiest moment of 2023.
Hey man, we gotta address the elephant in the room. When she said meow, meow, right?
Puff Daddy then turned her into Puff Cat. What is going on? She like Cat Daddy. What is going on with Lil' Kim, right? Meow, meow. We want our face back, Lil' Kim. We want our face back. We don't want it. No, no. Meow, meow.
Nah, just listen. No, we don't talk about it. Because as a comedian, you want people to do well, right? You do. You don't never want to see nobody do bad, dog. So I'm in the back and I hear meow, meow. And I was like, that must be like, all right. Then I heard again. I came around front like, hey, what the fuck is going on, dog? I got to host the second part of the show. And I know black people, dog. Hey, sir, one thing I know is I know my people, dog. They losing faith in the whole show. They was like, oh, so this is what I paid for this. So that's crazy. I was in line, y'all, VIP, and she's meowing. That's... So much pressure on me. I know the next nigga better not do no noises from an animal. I know that. And y'all think y'all mad. She had a dude up there. She had like a real, like a hard ass dude. She came up, he was like, meow. Come on, let's go. They gone. They not here. They in the car having a real conversation about goals and like decisions.
What's up, y'all? My name is Lonnie. We love celebrating birthdays at Chocolate Sundays. Sometimes it goes well and sometimes it doesn't, but it's always a good time. So check out our favorite birthday moments of 2023.
Who can sing? Who? You can sing, sir? Who else? Come on right there. Is it you?
Her.
Who?
Her.
Well, who the fuck is her? Is it you? Is that her?
Yes.
Okay, I just needed approval from black people. How you been approved by the black delegation? How are you? It was several Negroes in the back that pointed at you vigorously and said you could sing. Now your flannel says one thing, but the Negroes say another. What's your name? Brooker, where you from?
Santa Monica.
Oh, Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, she's about to woo you, and don't judge a book by its flannel. She's been recommended by seven of the finest Negroes in the back right there. And the hoodest one said, her! So without further ado, get up from Brooke from Santa Monica.
Happy
birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Joy. Happy birthday to you.
Mom, you want to sing? So why are you pointing at her if you're going to do it? But why are you yelling at me? I'm asking a question. Is she going to sing or not? Yes? Mom, come on down here. You got the wet and wavy. What's your name?
My name is Tasha.
Tasha, I believe you can sing. I think you can sing and you can make some good greens, too. Stand right here for a second. Listen. Can you sing Kimane Happy Birthday? Not the one that everybody know. Your version of it, okay?
Happy birthday to you.
You gotta sing. I thought you could sing. I can do that. If you're not gonna sing, are you gonna sing?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear.
I can do this part. Can you really sing? So neither you or your daughter don't have talent. What is going on? You said your mama can sing. Why would you bring her up here and embarrass herself like this? Ma'am, can you really sing or are you playing? Can you really sing? Because you're doing what I'm doing. And I'm a terrible singer. I know my gift. That's not my gift. No, you sing with your talking voice. Happy birthday to you. Happy. No.
Wait. Huh? Ryan, huh? You said she's singing with her talking voice.
Yeah. It was no riffs or nothing. Happy birthday to you. A cigarette. Happy birthday to you. Happy. I am singing. You aggressive like your daughter. Everybody aggressive. Ma'am, are you going to sing? This is your last chance. Are you really going to sing? Huh? If not, I'm going to plug this mic and I'm going to roast you. So bad. We wasting time. They got me on the schedule over here. Oh, okay. Okay. Okay, BB. BB. This better BB good too. Let's go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Ma'am, here you go. Have a good one. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You want to play the song? Let them use you, bro. I just want him to close his mouth. His mouth. Just close your mouth, bro. You got cavities in the back. Close your mouth. Where you from, Miles?
Washington.
Why did you say before I asked you where you from? Washington?
Yeah.
D.C. or Seattle?
State.
State. Mouth so lit.
I'm coming up there.
Come on. Come on.
Let them hate the money power. When your friend comes to hello, pressure speaking. Tower on the door, but that pressure reeking.
We have a great show for you tonight. Great fucking show.
Hey, y'all, show Miles Brown, everybody. Oh my God. Miles.
So here at Chocolate Sundays, you know we all about the laughs. I'm talking about the crazy laughs, the stomp it down, grab, knock shit over, everything type of laughs. That's what we into here at Chocolate Sundays. And this right here is one of our funniest laughing moments of the year 2023 right here at Chocolate Sundays. Check it out.
People laughed at when you're young and you laugh your syllables. You be like, that's three. You get old, you in pain, nigga, your whole side hurt right now. He got one syllable. niggas always say something when they finish laughing. Nigga. Let your shit out, man. Don't hold it in.
So here we are at the good stuff, y'all. We about to watch our YouTube clips, our top fives. That's why y'all come see us all the time. Y'all be in the comments. I'll be seeing y'all cutting up, acting a fool. Keep doing it. We love it. But these are the top five moments.
We used to tell our friends, hey, when I grew up, ain't none of us who the f- we thought we was gonna be. I don't mean to blow nobody high or f- up nobody's mood on this Sunday evening, but examine your own life. I don't know what you do, but I bet that ain't what the f- you thought you was gonna be when you was no little boy or no little girl. I know that. Big, what you wanted to be when you was a little ass boy? He was like, a stockbroker, cuz I did. You don't even have an E-Trade account. Do you trade stocks, my boy? Hell no. What you wanted to be? A football player. Mm-hmm. Told you BTB in 11th grade. Don't play football, do you? How far did you get in your football ambition? I started gangbanging, so it was over. Football team wore the wrong colors, cuz. God damn, he could have been an all-pro running back if they would have just wore blue, but they didn't. Or red, I don't know what neighborhood you from. I'm sorry.
I remember when there wasn't no such thing as fresh wipes. I remember when the only thing she could wipe that coochie with was toilet paper. And that toilet paper would leave remnants behind. Every real man over 30 and bust some cheeks open and had to pick a little cotton for your ancestors. Yeah, gotta treat that booty like aspirin. Get that cotton out the top. Yeah, you done got that tissue peel out of there one time, my boy. With that black girl, yeah, when he got that tissue peel out of there. And we ate that coochie anyway. And you know why we ate it anyway? Because we ate 9 laters where the paper didn't peel all the way off. And you ate that 9 later anyway. Didn't know you was gonna need them skills later on in life.
But the most toxic song of all. Michael had got some coochie from a lady one night, one evening. They had a beautiful time together. And then that lady moved on with her life. Got married. Married a rich nigga from Africa. He took her back to Wakanda or Zamunda or somewhere nice like that. Had built her a brand new palace. But like most women, she still wasn't satisfied. She's sitting over there bored. He don't know what to do to entertain her. He say, what must I do? So he started throwing little talent shows at the house. Started inviting all kind of niggas over to the house. Jugglers, swallow eaters. You know, niggas that be swallowing, eating shit, five swords, swallow eaters. Magicians and shit. And none of them niggas would entertain this lady. She still was not amused. 9 different niggas performed. Then the 10th nigga showed up. He wasn't even on the list. Magic Johnson didn't even know what to call him. He was like, and now, this nigga. And this nigga walked out in front of this lady and her brand new husband, all on these people, brand new flow, opened up a bag of dirt and pulled it all on these people, brand new palace flow, and walked the fuck off. And they was like, hey, what you gonna do about this dirt? And Michael spun his toxic ass out the dirt. Boom, 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 top, the boom, the boom, boom, boom. Do you remember? And she immediately recognized Michael. That's why she looked the fuck off. Like, I know Michael ass. Ain't in here talking about that one time we fucked, that one time at my brand new house in front of my husband. And she ignored Mike for the whole fucking song. But Mike would not be ignored. Who jumped out the dirt with him? All the background dancers. Mike had receipts. Mike started naming places. Do you remember on the phone after dark in the park? You and me, two or three. What about? Bruh, that's when he ate the pussy. Bruh, that.
I went on a gay date and I ain't know it. Hey, wait, hold on, let me tell you what happened first. In Hollywood, I'm at the gym, this dude 6'5 walk in. I'm like, oh, he on my squad, off back, you know what I mean? He gets on the court, we don't lose a game. So after the run, I'm like, hey, bro, you nice, man. I'm like, you played professionally? He's like, yeah, I did, played overseas. I don't play no more. He's like, hey, what you doing later? Nothing, I ain't doing nothing. I ain't doing nothing. He like, hey, I got Laker tickets. Put your number in this phone. You can roll. You want to roll? Yes, I want to go. Yeah. I offer you Laker tickets right now. You like, where you want me to be? So he give me the phone. I put my number in his phone. He like, cool, I'm going to come pick you up. I'm like, and you going to pick me up?
I can't speak for everybody, but for me, I think the biggest difference between white dudes and black dudes were the compliments. Yeah, I don't know if you dated a black guy, but if you dated a white one, you know they give the worst compliments I've ever heard in my life. Just terrible hype men, you know? Like any white dude I dated, the best I would ever get was just, oh, you look nice. I'm like, what are you, my fucking dad? Like, come on, man, I tried, you know? Black dudes are so good at compliments, they can take something you hate about yourself and make you love it. That's a skill. You can just show up and they'll be like, girl, that's cellulite? I'm like, stop. All right, you're making me blush.
She asked me the other day, because she said, damn. She goes, Mom, can I say a curse? I was like, well, what curse you want to say? She was like, can I just like freely say damn? That's what she said. Can I like freely say this, just say damn? And I say, you as you said, you about to be 18, you can say damn. I know damn well I can. I'm about to go to my damn room. Like, she go in her room, she's like, where is my slippers? I said, I think your sister took them downstairs. Well, I be goddamn.
I remember when the only thing she could wipe that coochie with was toilet paper. And that toilet paper would leave remnants behind. Every real man over 30 done bust some cheeks open and had to pick a little cotton for your ancestors. Yeah, gotta treat that booty like aspirin. Get that cotton out the top. Yeah, you done got that tissue peel out of there one time, my boy.
You gotta hang out with people who do the stuff you like to do. You have to. Like, I can't work out with people who not my size. Because when I work out with women who not my size, they want to do shit bitches my size don't do. Like, if I go hiking, in the middle of the hike, I get tired, and I say, I'm tired, my skinny friends will be like, girl, keep going. You could do it. We almost there. But if I hike with a girl my size, and we get halfway up the hike, and I say, bitch, I'm tired. She gonna be like, bitch, me too. We can finish this shit tomorrow. We, look at us. How many calories you burn? 1,000? Bitch, me too. That's enough. That's enough.
You ever bring up to your parents how they used to whoop you now as a grown-up? Y'all ever bring that? They be acting surprised and shit like, I never hit you. I told my mom, he used to beat the shit out of me. What is you talking about? My mom be trying to act like she got amnesia. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, that was acrobatic. Listen, man. BT Kingsley here. Listen, this is Chocolate Sunday staff's favorite moments of the year. I better be in there somewhere. I better be in there somewhere.
All right. Yo, what's up, guys? Albert Morrow here. I'm a photographer and videographer for Chocolate Sundays here at the Laugh Factory. My favorite moment of 2023 was being able to do a Sharpie henna tattoo on Brandon Brody for the Halloween show. Thanks to that, now in 2024, I'm going to be adding henna to my body art business that I have going. So hit me up for your henna tattoos or real tattoos. Hell yeah.
Trying to get a little frisky with your lady, but you don't have any condoms, so you go to the CVS to get some. Yeah, you walk up in there, you get to the cash register, you say, hey ma'am, I would like a pack of Sour Patch Kids and some. Exactly, and you get it in the 3-pack. Why? Because it comes in the styles for the teams he plays for. It makes too much fucking sense.
What up, this is Keon Poli, one of the hosts here at Chocolate Sundays, comedian. My favorite moment of 2023 had to be the cat lady. She got stuck on her set and literally just meowed at the crowd. Literally said, meow. I mean, we got footage. You can look at it right now.
Puff Daddy then turned her into Puff Cat. What is going on? She like Cat Daddy. What is going on with Lil' Kim, right? Meow, meow. We want our face back, Lil' Kim. We want our face back. We don't want it. No, no. Meow, meow.
Y'all ain't shit. I'm not gonna be the villain. Y'all ain't shit, man. Y'all ain't shit. Comedy hard, bro. Like, it is. We make this shit look easy. This shit hard, bro.
What's going on? It's your boy DJ Miles P. My favorite moment of 2023 is probably BET Weekend. Beyond Cole came.
I'm gonna do these jokes. I'm gonna leave real quick. So I'm just gonna run off a few and then get the fuck on out of here and shit.
T.I. came. Great environment, great atmosphere. Just a vibe. I was DJing. The crowd was lit. Everybody was lit, so I think that was my favorite weekend of the entire year, and can't wait for 2024. DJ Mouse
P. What's up, y'all? My name is Ivan Chapman, and I'm one of the videographers here at Chocolate Sundays. One of the moments that stand out to me the most is when Ron is dancing on the old Golden Grill Lane. And it was the most funniest, hilarious moment ever. Nigga took the glasses off and put his hand out. It was fun. I enjoyed it, Ron. Beautiful. Anybody want to
talk? Random question. So have you ever been with a black man before? Y'all saw that? Sidekick, you got some?
What's up, y'all? I'm DJ Sidekick, your favorite DJ, the DJ of all DJs of Chocolate Sunday. Been here the longest. I'm an ancient here. And I think the best time for me in 2023 is seeing the team put this shit together that y'all don't ever see. Like Chelsea running around with an attitude because somebody said something real fucked up to her and she got to keep the smile on her face so she come up here and cuss us out. You know, you don't know about that. And then like Kiki, you know, running around making sure everything is together for the birthdays. And you know, just, you know, Lonnie on my ass about playing old school music, you know, stuff like that. Stuff that y'all don't get to keep to go. I appreciate of 2023 of the team we have now. Because the team is awesome. Shout out to Chelsea. Shout out to Kiki. Shout out to Lonnie. Big Ben, my brother. His birthday was phenomenal. Crazy. You know, thankful, y'all.
Okay. Hi, I'm Chelsea. I'm outside. I'm inside. I'm around. I work here. Anyway, my favorite moment was when we celebrated Kira's 5 years of working at Chocolate Sundays, and Lonnie decided she wanted to get a balloon blown up before the show, because I recommended a helium tank so we could do it here, but she wanted to get the balloon. Did you know that balloons come in different sizes? There's an extra large one. It doesn't fit in my car, but it did. I got it all the way here, and I already have a phobia about balloons popping. Anywho, spoiler alert, I recorded people bringing it upstairs because I was like, oh, this will be so fun.
You gotta pivot.
I feel like I'm taking a couch pivot. Up the stairs. There we go. Oh.
This stair. Show them the stairs. That stairs. Popped. 2 minutes before the show, maybe 5 minutes before the show. The damn balloon popped. Tried to tape it, but it's ugly. So the journey continues. What do? Had to go to Target, find a new balloon. Long story short, we make it happen here. You never know what's gonna happen.
Okay, so what's up, everybody? My name is Kira. I'm the girl that you guys always ask where Lonnie is at. Nice to meet y'all. I'm also the editor. So my favorite moment of 2023, I have a couple, but my number one might be when there was a lawyer sitting in the audience, and he worked for what we're gonna call the mob, maybe the cartel. We're not sure. We don't want to know.
Jack, what do you do for a living? Y'all not listening. Y'all are not fucking listening. Y'all not listening to what he said. Cause y'all heard. Look, no. That nigga said for one family and then stopped smiling. That's some mafia shit.
I said.
On the one family.
Only one bomb.
Nigga, you do criminal defense for one family? And you making a living? That's a lot of goddamn crime. And he just sitting here looking at me creepy like, it sure the fuck is. Got some more jokes? Fucking disappear. You wanna swim with the fishes, bucko? You wanna fucking swim with the fishes? Italian mobster, cause you old, so I know you've been doing this shit for a long time. Where John Gotti at? Nigga, I know you know. God damn, 35 years, one family. Damn, you know what's crazy? You can't say nothing else. They fuck around being here. He get to say no more. I was like, who's the family? That nigga said one family. Where'd that nigga go? Oh, God. Okay, he's back. Jack, come back to your seat, bro. Shit. Y'all, make some room for fucking Jack. Move out his way. You good, man? Everything cool? All right. And they got that call.
I'll be Jack security.
I love black women. We can do anything. I need some niggas out of jail. You think them niggas can afford Jack, nigga? They been working for one family. Them niggas in that little pussy ass budget. If you don't get ghosted, Tariq the fuck out of here. With the Sopranos. You said good hair. He crossed his leg. He was like, now let's talk about this pussy and hair. Give me a second.
What was your favorite moment of 2023?
My favorite moment of 2023 was watching Kira when she got into that trip. Remember that? It was you and Aaliyah at the after party. Yes, yeah, that was my favorite party because it just reminded me, you know, it's family. You know what I'm saying? But
They did not have whatever appetizer you were talking about.
I'm Malachi. I am on the Chocolate Sundays team. I'm the laugh behind the camera. And I'm here with my girlfriend, Kayla.
Hey, yeah, I'm Kayla. I'm here all the time, pretty much with him. And I would say one of the funniest moments that I remember that actually happened recently is every other night, there's just like some silver fox kind of dude with a girl that looks like a sugar baby. And then there was just one specific couple that was there, and he was just trying to egg this girl on like, oh, would you do this? Would you kiss him and stuff? And she's like, oh yeah, yeah. Like, I'm just, and he, and then oh, he was just like, are you guys serious? He's like, no. She's like, no.
I remember.
And then he was just like, kiss him. And she's like, okay. And she kissed him. I was just like, I just loved it. It was just so funny. And situations like that in the front row always happen. And yeah.
So this is what happens when you settle it on down. Y'all know, well, you look like you just got her for tonight, but y'all been together. Am I right? Am I right? Am I right? Hell yeah! Call me now! Call me now! Y'all, I know, girl, you better get that money, shit! Don't play! Don't play!
Hey, everybody.
They kissing in the front row. Oh, Lord. Just, what's happening right now? All right. Now, y'all finished kissing? I don't want to interrupt y'all. Just, sis, you got to get your money. I'm not going to stop what's happening. I'm not a hater. Get your money. I see what's happening.
You see what's happening?
I see what's happening.
Yeah, we see it from up here.
He know what's happening.
Yeah, he happy as
f- It's probably his assistant.
She work at a county.
His wife think he in a staycation work meeting. It's a local thing. We're going to Hollywood. All my staffers going there to hang out.
Right.
Build some camaraderie. Cut to, he kissing the black girl in the front row. He's, sis, get your money. I ain't mad. Yeah. All right.
My favorite moment from this year was one time they, at the end of some shows, they do a happy birthday. And so Ron is the host. He's calling for somebody to do a happy birthday. This girl is upstairs. She is, I can sing it. I'm gonna sing it. She wants all the attention. She goes up there. She is like proud. She is, she grabs the mic and then she starts trying to sing happy birthday with the crowd. And Ron literally is like, no, 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 no. No, we're not doing that. And then he cuts her off. He makes somebody else come up. It was, she was like, she came there for her moment and it was just, it was so funny. Yeah, that's definitely my favorite moment from the year.
Okay, my favorite moment of 2023. I really hesitated in telling this because I don't want to take away from the sweetness that is Kira. Because she really is so sweet normally. But what I also love about Kira, which you find, which you don't find very much in life anymore or Hollywood, is honesty. And she really keeps it real. So, there was a comedian that performed, and you know, we sit in our booth, and a lot of times after they'll come and ask us how they performed, and it's always awkward, right? If someone doesn't do well, we don't want to say anything. We're normally like, oh yeah, you know, you did your thing, like, thank you for performing. But this guy came up to Kira in her face and was like, how did I do? What'd you think? And she was just like, she was like, did you laugh? Like, and she was like, no. He said, not even a little bit. And she goes, I cannot believe it. They act like I'm the villain of Chocolate Sunday. He's the real villain.
But this is the thing, right? If you ask somebody, do you want them to lie? Like, do you want them to lie to you? Do you want the truth?
They want a sugar-coated truth.
I do want the truth. Ones really doing your comedy journey. We're always rooting for them. But the honesty, I applaud the honesty because I couldn't do it. I don't lie. No ass. You don't want to.
Listen, man. Here at Chocolate Sundays, we're not just about handsome folks from Texas. That's not what we're just about. So what, my beard is immaculate? So what? So what, my bean looks okay? So what, you can hop on my DMs and be like, hey, how you doing? That's not what we're here. Here at Chocolate Sundays, we celebrate milestones. So many milestones, I can't even name all of them. But let's take a look at some of the biggest milestones of 2023.
So, Kira, do you know why you're up here? August 28th of 2018. Your first show was Labor Day weekend 5 years ago.
Damn. I'm sorry.
So we just want to bring you up here and say thank you. Chocolate Sundays would not be what we are in live, on digital, or anything without Kira and all the hard work. She literally is
like one of those magical people that always goes above and beyond. And I know that's a cliche thing to say, but she literally does way more than is asked of her and, you know, makes us better coworkers, us a better show. So we just want to thank you, Kira.
I started this show back in 1999 with a friend of mine. Yes, you can give it up for that. With 20, almost 24 years of running, and when Ida came and came on stage, it was at a time when a lot of female comedians were having a very tough time getting into this industry. And even today, it's not easy for them. They have a harder struggle than the guys. So when you get a comic who is committed, like Ida has been, you have to show the love because it's very, very difficult. And she's withstood the test of time. But not only that, she's been extremely successful in growing as a comedian. So give her a round of applause. Give it up louder, louder, louder. Show the love. We have comedians that, you know, a lot of times people think when they see you on television for the first time that you kind of had immediate gratification in your success story. And it's people that you guys see that you would consider successful. They've been putting in the work like this for 15, 16, 20 years before they make it. And I want to talk about what making it really means. A lot of times you think making it is being someone that you see on television and film or movies or and things like that. But making it for a comedian is being able to sustain your life doing something that you love to do, and you can make enough money to support yourself, your family, your friends, and so forth. And she is a living example of that. She's not only a comedian, she's a writer, she's a producer, she's a director. She is a all-purpose comedian. So I don't want to get emotional, but I love you to death. That's why I came here tonight. Lonnie told me you were coming for 16 years, and it's important. So one more time, give her a round of applause, guys. Ida Rodriguez.
Can I ask, because I think you would know.
Go ahead.
When you decide to go into the ministry, Aaron, you can answer to, like, when you decide to fully transition, do they send the shirt with the hat? Like, do they send it together? Because it's not giving, Pastor.
BT, it comes with the shoes, too.
It comes with the shoes. With no socks.
Yeah, no socks.
It's because Jesus was barefoot. Why would you wear socks?
You wear socks, Lord.
If Jesus didn't wear socks, why would I wear socks? Kid, it's not even, it don't even look like a pastor. It looked like a nigga that swear he know God in the barbershop. It's an old nigga in the barbershop. Hey, that nigga, BT, he dressed like he run the numbers for Bumpy Johnson, don't he? Come on in the back after the air and jump up and pray for you.
Hey, Ron. It's crazy he finna go into ministry, but he dressed up here like a lesbian.
Nigga! Nigga dressed like a softball coach.
You gonna tell him?
Too soon?
All right. I'm at the show. You gonna tell him? I'm at the show. Hello. Jesus says your hat ain't shit. I told him. He said he don't normally curse like that, but if you gonna wear the outfit, he said he don't want no credit for it.
Nigga.
You look like the manager of the bowling alley when your pin's stuck. Like, nigga, you like, I got it. Boo, I got it.
I know, Aaron, this is like my boy, and I'm just wondering, like, you're not doing comedy no more, so I'm like, he used to have some bitches in comedy.
Used to invite him to Bible study.
You know what I mean? So I'm just wondering, at the church, man, is going to be crazy. Hey, man. Let me put hands on you. Stay after church. Let's talk about it. Let's talk. Because he used to have a little set. He used to have them. I used to watch him working at the gym. He knew the jokes, man.
Talking to your teeth.
Let's talk about it.
me and Aaron from the same city. In St. Louis. And I love, doing like the quarantine, we had Bible study together on Zoom. Like, we really did. So I knew he was about to probably take this leap. It's amazing that he's being so obedient to follow God to save his life when God didn't save his hairline. And I just think that's amazing.
We fall down. But we get up. His hairline fell down.
He's a better man than me.
Hey, hey, this is Ben, Big Teflon, Walton, Chocolate Sundays original, inventor of the Chocolate Sundays Late Show. You know what I'm saying? Been here forever. Not going nowhere. I want to thank everybody out there for tuning in and supporting Chocolate Sundays Comedy Show. We put a lot of work into giving you guys a good show. And you guys give us all the energy back that we need to let us know we're doing a great job. We really sincerely appreciate you from the bottom of our hearts. As 2023 comes to an end, I hope you had a good year. Hope that 2024 brings you a better year. I know we got more stuff coming. We got bigger and better things, more innovative ways to bring you comedy, more innovative ways to keep you guys laughing, keep you guys engaged, and more innovative ways that you guys give us your input so we can give you what you really want. Okay? Chocolate Sundays Comedy Show, ChocolateSundays.com. Shout out to the whole staff. Holla at your boy. Peace.
What is this condom on the mic, Lonnie? What are we doing? Why is it matched the stool? Y'all doing too much. There's already too much shit up here. I can't move. And now you color coordinated. Everything matching. Spalding orange.
What the happened? This shit. God damn it. Clean this shit up. Clean this shit up. I'm gonna knock that shit down again in a minute. Watch this.
Okay, she watches the show like. I don't feed the comedians. How come it's a chunk missing out the mic?
CP, we can hear you, nigga. The class can hear you, nigga.
A lot of people don't know, man. CP, very funny dude, dog. Very funny dude, dog. Very funny, man. He was about to play a lesbian in a movie, but they went on strike, so you're not gonna be able to see it, but. I seen some of the footage and that nigga killed it. You hear me? I thought he was Queen Latifah the whole time. All right.
I need water.
You a tourist?
You know, they said you couldn't close. You know, I heard they said you couldn't close Chocolate Sundays.
I mean, like.
I don't know.
It's 2 a.m.
It's 4:47 a.m. Chocolate Sundays. Period.
I love the fact that Lonnie believed that I could close the show, and I did. But I love her because she saw something to me that I didn't see myself. Plus, I was tired because I landed today and I was going to sleep. But
make sure y'all dress up next week.
Like, period. Like,
thank you very much.
Close it.
We come
to the end. So dumb. Oh, my bad.
I tell you that you're the same.